Eddie Pepitone, congratulations on yet another Emmy Award.
Thank you, David, but I've won so many times I'm no longer pleasantly surprised. Now I'm just enjoying being completely jaded about it.
What is it now, like 8 years in a row?
9, David. By now, people are afraid to vote against me.
Why would the Academy be afraid to vote against you?
I threaten them, David.
You're kidding, right?
Excuse me?
So, once again, Eddie Pepitone tonight won for Best Comedy Variety Series.
That's right, David.
Which is even more amazing considering you're on radio.
It doesn't even make any sense, David.
We've put together some highlights of the evening. Do you mind if we play them?
If you don't, we're going to be sitting here for the next 8 minutes talking about Minka Kelly.
Why would we do that?
Because I can't stop thinking about it, David.
Okay, Eddie, first we got a clip of you on the red carpet.
That red carpet was amazing.
Really?
It covered the entire patio.
Thank you, Charlie Sheen. Wasn't he gracious, ladies and gentlemen? Somebody hire this man. Look, it's Eddie Pepitone of Eddie Pepitone Tonight. Hi, Eddie.
Hello, Mark Thompson.
Eddie, we're big fans of Eddie Pepitone Tonight.
Thank you, Mark, and I always enjoyed your weather reports in the 80s. They still hold up.
Thanks, Eddie. And who's this lovely lady on your arm?
Oh, her? I don't know her name. We just met in the car on the way over here.
Nice to meet you.
Eddie, very handsome.
I think she's Ukrainian. I didn't bring a globe with me. To be perfectly honest, I don't care. I just want to look at her.
Well, I don't blame you, Eddie. That's a beautiful dress she's wearing, by the way. Vera Wang?
Don't try to guess her name. That'll take forever.
I meant, is her dress Vera Wang?
How would I know that? I'll tell you this, though. That dress cost me even more than she did.
Eddie, Kalinchenko!
I told you already. I'll stop at the ATM after the show.
Нет! Столичная!
Can you believe it, Mark Thompson? She doesn't take credit cards.
I offer Groupon.
Well, good luck tonight, Eddie. I have a feeling that you're going to take home that Emmy.
No, I think her name's Katrina.
Oh, look, it's Steve Carell from The Office. Come over here, Steve. I don't want to jinx anything, but I have a very good feeling about your chances tonight.
Now, you and your sidekick, Frank Conniff, presented the award for Best Dramatic Series.
Yeah, Frank really made me look bad out there.
Really? Because I thought you two were great, Eddie.
I was, at first. Then Frank wouldn't get out of my way.
Let's roll that clip.
Here we are, Eddie, at the 63rd Annual Emmy Awards. It's quite a night, huh?
Well, Frank, I'm just glad we were able to get your head out of the punch bowl.
Because I drink too much, right, Eddie?
No, Frank, because you like to see how long you can hold your head under vodka.
Eddie, I think we should stop joking around and just read the nominees.
Well, why don't I do the reading and you can look like a sloppy drunk in a rented tux?
The tux isn't rented.
Hey, anybody out there need one you sidekick?
The nominees for Best Drama Series are Boardwalk Empire,
right, they should call it Bored Out of My Skull Empire.
Eddie, I think most people like that show.
Shut up, Frank, to expect me to be a reverend.
Next, we have Dexter.
What kind of crappy show is this? A psychotic nut plays God? Big deal. That's every manager I've ever had. That includes you, Alex Murray.
Eddie, they just want to know who won.
Fair enough. And the winner is Friday Night Lights. Sounds like Jewish people with candles.
Eddie, you didn't read the other nominations.
Who cares, Frank? They lost.
Eddie, it says it's Mad Men. Mad Men won.
Oh, no, no, no. I'm sorry. It was Mad Men.
Mad Men won.
Sit down, you Friday Night Light assholes.
Friday Night Lights, but we're really sorry. You do great work. Please sit down.
Now, Friday Night Lights, sit down. Go back to your seats.
Mad Men people, please, please come to the stage.
Mad Men, you come up!
Friday Night Lights people, please put the Emmy down. Stop hitting the trophy girl. It's not her fault.
I made a mistake. It happened. All right? Mad Men was a better show. Even though I don't care for slow things about advertising.
Eddie, you really did it this time.
Friday Night Lights, come on. Mistakes happen. Like your show getting picked up. Just kidding. No, I'm not.
And finally, when you guys won, Eddie, again, another great moment at the Emmys.
I'm running out of ways to look gracious, David.
I think it speaks for itself. Roll it.
And the winner for Best Comedy Variety Series is Eddie Pepitone Tonight!
Surprise. Let's get all the writers up here. Come on, guys. Maybe this is the year your parents finally accept that you're only in show business. That's right, folks. All 27 of these prima donnas work for me. Jeez. Look at them. I gotta hold my nose and hire a couple of broads. Or maybe just one black guy. Have you tried the shrimp backstage, folks? I've never seen that much shrimp in my life. I couldn't shovel it in fast enough. Then I heard my name, and I almost wish I'd lost because it was so delicious. Hey, I don't care how successful you are, folks. There's nothing like free shrimp. Okay, I'm gonna shut up now and let my writers talk because this award is for them. They work hard, and God knows I'm not the easiest person to work for.
He's right about that.
Who said that? You're lucky I don't know your voices. Anyway, let me just say my piece and I'll let these guys thank their mommy and daddy. By the way, wasn't Jane Lynch great tonight? She's so talented you can almost forget she's a lesbian. Almost. I think it's great that those people can rise up through the ranks despite the social stigma, the awkwardness, and lack of acceptance that some of them have brought on themselves.
Eddie, I'd wrap it up right about now.
What? Let's face it. They're a little on the angry side. Watch it, ladies. You can attract more flies, etc., and so forth and so on. Think about it. Excuse me, folks. I ate a lot of shrimp, and you're all getting kind of blurry. Anyway, one more thing, and I'll let these geniuses talk. The executive producer of this show's name is Mark Burnett. Let me tell you people something about Mark Burnett. He's an anti-union son of a bitch.
Eddie, I'd wrap it up.
That's right. Mark Burnett wants to destroy all the unions in Hollywood. This Mark Burnett, who's from England, by the way, sneaks into this country and takes jobs away from American executive producers. Plus, he creates reality shows, which we all know are worthless crap. And steals work from writers and actors. Then he hires to host this show Jane Lynch, a tall, popular, multi-talented lesbian to distract you while he makes billions of dollars exploiting American labor. I know for a fact that Mark Burnett hired scabs to write for this show. which is against the law, and he has a history of labor violations.
But that's not supposed to matter, because he's successful, which is the only thing that's important in Hollywood. Yeah! My point is, Mark Burnett is a very bad guy, all right? Yeah! Said it. He's an anti-union son of a bitch, and I'm against everything he stands for.
Eddie, what the hell are you talking about? You love Mark Burnett, and you hate unions, too.
You're right, Frank. Sorry, folks. It must have been the shrimp. I don't feel well. Was doing a left-wing bit. If you don't like it, blame my writers. What are you guys looking at? You won your Emmy, didn't you? That's it. Back to the office. You gotta finish the Mitt Romney bit tonight. The first man who cries is fired. You heard me. Let's go, girls.
Please welcome two hot stars spicing up primetime, Sofia Vergara and Rob Lowe.
You made history, Eddie. Emmy history.
When I called out Mark Burnett?
No, when you projectile vomited onto Jon Stewart from the podium.
Oh, yeah, I ad-libbed that.
Nice.